up in the club, putting squad up. Throw your squad up. Throw your squad. If I tell you that. We rocking out on that DTF radio on a Sunday. It's all about that Mother's Day vibes. We rocking. I go by the name of DJ Chaz. Let's go. New York, what's up? Definitely shout out the whole Tri-State area on the check. We rocking on that Butters Basic. It's going to be a lit one today. Definitely shout out to all my mothers. Like I said, we vibes it from early. Follow me on that gram. Shit is lit. Let's go.
Cause you fine, yeah. Got it, you cause you mine, yeah. Watching you like a diamond. I love the way that we shine. Yeah, life we live in a simple. I understand it take time. Yeah, understand what I've been through. My love for you is my sign. Yeah, I don't really trust nobody else. My feelings are for you. I swear it's for nobody else. I'm grinding till the sun up while I stack up on my wealth. And yeah, this all for you, cause girl, I want you to myself. And you won't never struggle, don't you call nobody else. Say, girl, I be your muscle while them commas chase themselves. You know I.
You the type to play your cards right. Leave your homegirls and stay out all night. Get excited when you find out the price. Love me like your first piece of ice. Or your favorite pair of nice. Either scenario, I'm what you're wearing. Style, no comparing.
It's your girl, Kez, so it's nothing representing for you to share them. DJ Taz, you know when you hear that name, that the man now
go
come
on my play landing.
Nah, Molly,
pay you a visit when
Taz.
I can.
Turn up,
and when
turn
I see
up,
you,
turn.
Don't be acting different. No. Do with them losers, now you back to winning.
No, you don't need no man. Girl, you get it on your own. No, we don't need no drugs. We already in our zone.
Like I said, we rocking out on that DTFradio.com. Follow me on that Instagram at DJ TAZMADD, the number one. It's lit.
Back to winning. Yeah, yeah.
We built this so I'ma stand on it. Ain't right, let's me and my man own it. Know the bottom because we came from it. And ain't surprised cause we planned on it. Conversation never ran from it. $1 million conversations, product placement. Trying to keep up but they out of date. Out of breath, out of line, all the way out of shape. Now they hate, if I roll it up it gotta be great. Bank account look like what the lottery say. Any time of day, put a couple low riders in your face. One go but she probably stay. Running game had ought to be played. 10 years ain't nobody take a shot at me. If it ain't cruise life, don't try to ride with me. One in the back, one on the side of me. In and out like a robbery. And the eyes
girl,
never lied to me.
No, man. Girl, you get it on your own. No, we don't need no drugs. We already in our zone. Oh, you got it right back. Right back, right back. Right back, right back. Oh, you're back to winning. Oh, back to winning. Yeah, yeah.
You don't love me, don't tell me you love me. Cause I can go fuck on your friend. I can hook up with your buddy. I ain't got time to pretend. I'm trying to give me some cut. And I ain't really trying to be friends. I'd rather get to the money. I tried to talk to the hoe. Told her my dreams and she looked at me funny. Everything I done dreamed, I done it. Everything I done dreamed, I done it. Now I done it, it's time for some more dreams.
Like I said, I go by the name of DJ Taz, man. I'm rocking, let's go. Also, do remember each and every Thursday, you can catch me inside of that paper rain. Gentlemen's Club is lit. Also, every Tuesday, catch me inside of 5 Spot.
Let me see acting. I'm treating the show like the streets. We pull up and count up the back end. You don't love me, don't tell me you love me. Cause I can go fuck on your friend. I can hook up with your buddy. I ain't got time to pretend. I'm trying to give me some cut. And I ain't really trying to be friends. I'd rather get to the money. You don't love me, don't tell me you love me. Cause I can go fuck on your friend. I can hook up with your buddy. I ain't got time to pretend. I'm trying to give me some cut. And I ain't really trying to be friends. I'd rather get to the money.
She trying to freak on the low low. She trying to cheat on the boyfriend. He keep on blowing the phone up. Press the red button, you know
him. I got the bags of the low end. I got the bags of the O end. That's a good number, don't be cheap. If you buy more than 10, it's gonna decrease. We
selling gas like we BP. Watch how you creep when you see me. We on the screens of they TV. Bad bitches download my CD. Sucks for you, you ain't believe me. You took the boy for a joke. I held it down, I ain't hoop. I was down bad, I was broke. They wanted my heart and my soul. I stay on my grind and I grow. Got this K and it's not on my blow. I ain't wasting no time on the hoe. So bitch, you don't love me, don't tell me you love me. Cause I can go fuck on your friend. I could hook up with your buddy. I ain't got time to pretend. I'm trying to give me some cut. And I ain't really trying to be friends. I'd rather get to the money. You don't love me, don't tell me you love me. Cause I can go fuck on your friend. I could hook up with your buddy. I ain't got time to pretend. I'm trying to give me some cut. And I ain't really trying to be friends. I'd rather get to the money. Buy whatever you can read about it. I got 27 hoes blowing up my phone, trying to come and suck the semen out. They staring at us, say, where we go. You gotta be yourself, you wanna be around me. And I'm staying low from all the broke hoes and the fuck niggas. I don't need them around me. Got a book to show you wanna see about me. Cause I ain't got no time to celebrate. I'm going in. The streets used to love me when I ain't had nothing. But now that I'm up there, I wanna be friends. I try to do right now. Y'all turned it back on me. Something I won't ever go through again. No time for no hoes and no friends. No time for no hoes and no friends. Cause I ain't got no time to celebrate, I'm going in. The streets used to love me when I ain't had nothing. But now that I'm up there, I wanna be friends. I try to do right, now y'all turned it back on me. Something I won't ever go through again. I'm tapping over no friends. I'm tapping over no friends. I got a new bitch that told me that she don't want shit from me. And I got another bitch claiming she's sick of me. Still asking what she can get from me. And I know a bro nigga having his hand out. He wanna act like a friend now. And they wanna smoke until I blew their mans down. Tryna act like they fans now. I pray to God that they all understand now. Play with me and some man down. I'm in the city in a rental van now. Tryna sell me a damn pound. They give me a deposit to come out the house now. I get paid to go out now. Charlotte ain't no other way to get out now. Let you show what you about now. Got everybody running around with a stick now. Just lay down and get down. Talk on the internet, don't make a diss now. It's already lit now. Go tell the associate you need some all black. Go pick out a fit now. My life in the history books. Whatever I do, they won't ever forget now. And that's why I stay out. Cause I ain't got no time to celebrate. I'm going in. The streets used to love me when I ain't had nothing. But now that I'm up there, I wanna be friends. I try to do right now. Y'all turned it back on me. Something I won't ever go through again. No time for no hoes and no friends. No time for no hoes and no friends.
Baby.
Bitch.
Baby yeah. Talk fire.
Fuck a nigga mean, nigga.
Baby talk.
Fuck you talking about.
Yeah.
I'm on their ass today. I just went and picked me up a bag today. I put up on the scene with a bad little bae. She got a fat ass when I smashed her shake. Smacking ass playing patty cake.
Like
shut
I said,
the fuck
I'm
up,
out,
do
I'm
what daddy
DTF
say.
Radio
I think I got
the
baby
Sunday,
mad at me. Fuck
the
bae, she look bad
Happy
today.
Mother's
told her,
Day,
I been
let's
away.
Go.
We can go get it fixed. I'ma drop the bitch off of my sis. She just as soon as she done with that nappy ass, you can call up your boy to come pick up his bitch.
Damn.
Look at my wrist, that's a brick. I just fucked up my Rolex, but fuck it, it's
damn.
I don't give a fuck about no fame and no chain and no jury. Put me on the lick.
Damn.
I just went inside with the label. Niggas offered me a contract. Told them niggas I ain't want it. The shit was whack, I didn't sign that. I'm the best, but never mind that.
Okay.
My shit so hard that they rewind that. Got that work if you can't find that.
Huh?
You can't afford it, we can finance. I got one foot in the trap, got one foot up the ass, that your coat on the rock. Got my dick in your bitch, should be bending it over and buzzing it open and throwing it back. I'm trying to go fuck a buddy. Fuck all the yoga, they don't really love me. I'm trying to give me some motherfucking money. If they're free me milk, why they ain't free my cousin? I bet we shoot up your motherfucking party. If somebody touch me, it's one of my brothers. I bet one of these niggas that talk on the internet, try me, they see me in public. I bet they play, I'm a motherfucking teacher. Bitch, I don't rap, I be motherfucking preacher. I bet you pay for that motherfucking show, and I bet you pay for that motherfucking feature. Bitch, I'm on they ass today. I just went and picked me up a bag today. I put up on the scene with a bad little bitch. She got a fat ass when I smashed her shake. Smacking her ass playing patty cake. Shut the fuck up, do what daddy say. I think I got a little baby mad at me. Fuck it, let's go to the bank.
Baby, baby, racks, racks. Keep them on me like I live in the bank. Pints, did it dessert like I live out of drink. My fashion is high, I live in the sky. I'm keeping my fire. I hope they don't try. You heard I'm on fire, but that ain't no lie. My youngins, I love them, I know they gon' ride. Get them knocked off and won't think about it. Taking off again, suicide doors, I don't let them in. 4 or 5 cars, living like a thug, paying for my sin. And it's like they don't be in the corner. I can hop in the Benz before. Margo said they come in the morning. I got vibes in the state, I got choice. Gucci coat, I be standing on the corner with me. I gon' straight out the apartments, I'm rich as a bitch. I get mine out the toilet, the bro keep the dick. Put an A in, I learn to stand up for my seat. I was reading up daily, they thought I was kid. I was putting my profit up, save me a minute.
Like I said, it's all about that Mother's Day mix. I'm rocking out DTFradio.com.
Any kind of way I wanna, she know.
Definitely shout out each and everyone on there checking right now. We working, what's up?
Like we hit the number. I done got the ball, I fucking cannot fumble. Still ducking the laws, I gotta keep on running. I be rocking new shit.
shit, I got every color. This shit ain't enough, I need another. Come pull up any kind of way.
Like I said, it's all about that Butters Basic Show. Each and every Sunday, 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. It's your boy DJ Taz, I'm in the mix. Let's go.
Laws, I gotta keep on running. I'm like a new shit, I got every color. This shit ain't enough, I need another. Come up.
Oh, we got a special guest in the building today, too. Shit is definitely lit.
I spit a 20 on quick piece. I run it back like a pig six. Add it all up, it's a real me. I'm ballin', I need equipment. I just bought a lip kit. See, she fell in love with a misfit. And fuck your opinion, you know how I'm living. My closet say to be continued. Back in the days, I used to make plays. I spun dibs off of Virginia. Ain't no contender. Tattoo my name on placentas. I read a bitch like a count. May have a mill in a wrench. All of my verses are suspenseful. My cuz a blood minstrel. He draws down pounce. I know that you care for your answer. A baller need me an agent. I just might be your replacement. I got a whole lot of money, but I got a little patience. I got a whole lot of money, but I got a little patience. I got a whole lot of money, but I got a little patience. My bitch a trip vacation. Too many chains plantation. If you a real nigga, it ain't no expiration.
Pull up any kind of way I wanna, she know. I got that dope up in summer. Drop top winter, spring, fall, or summer. Young niggas ballin' like we hit the number. I done got the ball, I fucking cannot fumble. Still
that
gonna
like I said, definitely shout out each and everyone locked in on that live right now. It's lit, it's lit, it's lit.
Pull up any kind of way I wanna, she know. I got that dope up in summer. Drop top winter, spring, fall, or summer. Young niggas ballin' like we hit the number. I done got the ball, I fucking cannot fumble. Still that in the laws, I gotta keep on running. I'm like a new shit, I got every color. This shit ain't enough.
Just a crumble, no flood, my timepiece with emeralds. Not conservative, no liberal. Donate Rolex for Christmas. Heard I shop at Bar Harbor. I spend reckless on dinner. She so fine, got an added. Fuck told my folks where to send them. New Rari, help her M. See the horse, know the emblem. It's big goo up, it's him. Always us over them. Niggas say they don't do this and that, then duck when I say them. Don't compare me to Slim. I could never be him. Cop so many new baguettes that don't get sick of myself. Big really push my pills, so now I pick on myself.
Hey, but I swear to you, I would not lie. Right? I've been out here doing this music thing for a minute. I've been around so many artists. The vibes is lit. We got a lot of artists out here that call themselves artists, and they're not really putting in that work. They're not really putting in that pain. No lie, I've seen a lot of artists perform. And Gucci's one of my favorites. I'm not jocking nobody, gang. I'm not doing none of that, looking for publicity. Gucci is a dope, he's a dope artist. He do his thing. Gucci Mane, yeah, dope artist. His stage performance, I'm going to tell you something too, right? A lot of artists, they like to come on stage with their whole entourage. They pull up with 100 dudes in the spot, and their performance is garbage. I had the opportunity to see Gucci Mane perform in New Jersey.
In person. Talk about it.
Brooke and Conan opened up for him in
awesome.
New Jersey.
Awesome. Shout out to Brooke and Conan. Yeah, facts. YNBS.
And, that was the experience. Like, he came out on stage, and that was really crazy. Like,
talk about it.
The energy even brought me to him even more, because the funny thing about it was I was expecting him to come out with a whole entourage, a bunch of gold and diamonds, money flying on the stage, all of that, right? And it was funny because the situation was really different. It was him and Keisha K.R. They came, him and his wife.
She came out?
It was the both of them.
That's
on the stage.
Awesome.
Through the whole performance. I would not kid you. The whole performance was him and his wife.
I love that.
That just threw me on another level. It was like, yo, like business. Like, that shows you a lot about the game and how you go about certain things.
So I just want to let everybody know that all their mics are up. Aknazi's in the building.
What up?
This is the Butters Basic Show, the platform for the unknown to get known. And it's not because, don't be sorry, hun. This is the platform for the unknown to get known. And it's not because nobody knows you where you think they know you, but we are internationally local here at the Butters Basic Show. Somebody needs to know you elsewhere. And this is what we do, is the exposure. And also, unknown to get known means we're defeating X amount of ignorance to the 10th power. So if there's anything that you don't know, you're going to find out and want to research that, just because the Butters Basic Show is the one and the only platform for the unknown to get known. I'm not scared to let people know.
All facts.
It's what time it is. Taz did the mix today here at the Butters Basic Show. DJ Taz in the building. Shout out to DJ Oso as well.
You already.
Many other DJs that are in the industry, I fuck with y'all. I love y'all because you don't get paid to come and be a part of the industry, but because you know what's necessary to keep this thing going in the hip-hop culture appropriately, you do what you do. You might get criticized here and there,
yeah,
But at the same time, you're in the mix of everything that's going on of the now. Even though you were the then, you provide the platform for the unknown to get known without even knowing that that's what you're doing. My name is Butter. Hi, everybody. I'm not live yet, but at the same time, I will go live so you can see what I do. I got my co-host today, Pee-wee D. He's a comedian extraordinaire. Talk about yourself, honey. Oh. He's quite comfortable. Leaning back. Leaning back. Lean back. Lean back.
Nice chair. Y'all can hear me?
Yes, yeah, we can.
Okay. I'm just regular.
He's regular not fun. Regular, guys. He's regular funny fun. As fuck.
As fuck.
This guy, yo. If fucks were funny and you meant to laugh at some of them till you get to your wifey or your husband,
they will both go to
all the fucks before that was funny as fuck. That's this guy right here.
I got a song called Giggity Giggity. I need a comedian.
Don't worry.
Hey,
listen, man. I remember when Chris Tucker was a comedian on so many different levels of people's comedy. Michael Jackson.
Yeah. Facts.
Shout out to Michael Jackson. You know.
See, that was back when the videos was the big shit. A lot of comedians was getting looks off of that. You know what I mean?
Chris Tucker was my boy, yeah, Eddie Murphy. We had a few of them, man. They was lit.
It's funny, on the Banana song, I said, in peace, rest Mike Jackson.
Wow.
Yeah, rest in peace, Michael Jackson. I still fuck with Michael heavy.
Yo, who doesn't?
Yeah, some people. Like R. Kelly, I don't give a fuck what nobody said. That nigga make the most illest songs ever, nigga.
It's lit. You my boy.
Like he was, it was like,
listen,
boy.
Yo, Taz is crazy as fuck because Taz supports R. Kelly 180%.
Can I say something? I went to an event the other night.
Aknazi on the mic, y'all.
They said, sometimes I like to be quiet and take the undercut, but you can't when things are being said and you have to shed light on. Truth is light, and when darkness comes and light comes, darkness goes away. So they said, make a long story short, yo, man, R. Kelly, Michael Jackson, everybody was like, Michael, R. Kelly guilty at this event. First of all, there's no such thing as criminal law in America. Nobody is guilty. It's about money, but that's a whole nother topic.
I love where this is going.
That's a whole nother topic.
Nah, but we
this
on
is
that
our
today.
Land.
We on that today.
That's a
talk
whole
nother
topic.
This is why we need to
the Bill of
that
Particulars.
That
if you look at your whole system, the whole thing, decision, your whole...
Yeah.
System is about money. It's crazy. It's not even
nobody know they never even signed the Emancipation Proclamation.
None of them guilty. Into it. Because Nazi, you were incarcerated for like a year and change.
Yeah.
Right?
Sadly.
Sadly. Because you beat that charge.
Yeah.
In that year and change that you were incarcerated, what was the losses that came to you on a personal level? And you beat the charge because that means that you're not guilty. It's called exoneration.
Yeah. At trial. The only person who can understand what I went through, or anybody in, like, shout out to, you know, Bundy from Linden. Anybody who went on the stand, had a serious charge like murder, kidnapping, and said, I'm innocent, O.J. Simpson, and walked out in America, that feeling... You're not going to get it from a misdemeanor. The max is a year on a misdemeanor.
Well, I got a bachelor's in criminal justice. I can.
I got an
extensive police record.
I didn't know it until this.
Right.
Everything I've been through in life.
Show them the stack.
That's
the
this
camera
is nothing.
Right there.
Show this is nothing.
Show this. That's a camera right
baby
there.
Baby phone book.
Show them
nothing.
How thick the stack was.
This is nothing.
It's real.
You know what's funny? I started to bring the stack because it's this much of pictures, it's this much of DNA, it's this much of, you know, statements, it's this much of grand jury, it's this much of this, it's this much of investigation.
Yeah,
they give you everything. It's this much paper.
So you blew trial?
I know.
I won trial.
I know.
If I would have blew trial at 26 counts, which the proof is here, 26 counts.
Right.
They could give you the max on each count. You blow trial on a misdemeanor, that's a year.
You cost them
a
lot of money.
And so okay, so now if they decided that it was more than a misdemeanor, what would that have been? What was the time that you were facing?
Well, they offered me 15. Then right before trial, they was willing to go to 10. And from the beginning, they offered me to make a statement on this person that I don't know for the record. And I told them from day one, they found him in North Carolina. You know what he said? I don't know this man.
Right.
And still, even though they don't know this man, they still decided that we're still going to go to trial with evidence. Where did they get this evidence from?
What's the particulars of the case? Like, what happened? If you don't
I'm
mind.
So glad you're here, Pee, with your criminal justice
two people,
jiggity
two
joint.
Two people got kidnapped in 2012. They got home invaded. carjacked, beat with a gun, tied up. They took $50,000 for them.
$250,000
50 racks.
Right. From each of them.
No, from these people.
It's a nice haul right there. My last
so obviously, so wait, so obviously it's somebody that knows.
No, it was
somebody
an inside
that
job.
Knows that what they had.
Listen,
to come
I have
get
all
it.
The paperwork. It was an inside job. And definitely Malcolm was. Bryant, he became a federal informant. He lives in Newburgh, New York. Malcolm Bryant, who was Dominic McKenzie's friend. Yeah, I'm saying governments and names because we on a platform. Malcolm Bryant, I have his whole paperwork. He's already, it's already exposed. He became a federal informant when he got picked up. He said that he set this job up because Dominic owed him drug money. Dominic told him he did it with a guy named Nas.
Which is wow. Aknazi.
So they didn't go after Nas the rapper.
They went after
like that,
Nas.
They went after Nas.
Okay. Okay.
So Nas,
so not
Nas,
Nas
really caught me a case.
AZ and
so when I
and
sat
Nas
on when
them.
I sat on the stand and the dude looked at me, when he walked in, the man
pointed you out on the stand.
No, when Malcolm Bryant came on the for identity hearing, there was no jury.
Right.
He walked in. I looked back at him. I looked at my lawyer. I said, I never seen him one day in my life. Even if I knew him, I saw him or something. I said maybe it was a way I got caught up in this. So it was an identity hearing. They almost kicked me out the courtroom because I looked at him. I said, bro. I don't know you, bro. This is my life here, bro. I've never seen you one day, son. Don't lie on me, bro. So
how are we gonna? How are we gonna? You get to speak to this person?
Nah, I wasn't supposed to. Yeah, he came to the identity hearing yeah. before trial.
Right.
So he's on the stand. It's me. The DA walks up and they say, "So you know this Nas, right?" They put my government, Jeremiah Nasir, Jeffers, Abdullah, whatever. You know this Nas? They used the AKA, but threw the whole government in there. And threw a pit. I swear, everything I'm saying is so true. They put a picture of me on top of the table. He's sitting right there. They said, do you recognize this man? Do you see him in the courtroom? He looked at the picture. He looked at me. He looked again. He looked at me. He said, yeah, let the record reflect that the witness has positively identified the defendant. My lawyer ate him up. Is it safe to say that if you ain't
how?
Seen
how? If he didn't say, yes, I know him.
She said, if you didn't see that picture, would you recognize him? He already, objection, overruled. Well, let me rephrase. If it was a courtroom full of people and we said, where's Nas at? And he was sitting in the courtroom, would you pick him out? How do you even know? I seen him around. Where did you see him around the town?
This is the lawyer. Instructing the gentleman
because
to
it's
say
a known
she,
fact.
She
it's
ate him
known,
up.
It's a known fact nowadays when they put down those pictures with like different pictures of people and they tell them is it number 1, 6, 3, 4, 5. People, you know, their memory be messed up. It's very inaccurate, but it shouldn't even be admissible in court like
okay.
that. For real.
They ate him up.
The system is a different story. Like
I didn't know this, before. But at a trial, the judge can ask you questions.
Yes, of course.
Woo! After the DA, after the cross-examination,
the judge said,
where was you when you met Nas? He said, I was in the car. Dominic was in the passenger seat. And what was going on? Dominic had some jury to show Nas. First of all, the only other witness who lied about me, that's a whole nother topic that I'm going to say in all a right. second, said that I had some jury. Well, your main witness is saying Dominic had jewelry. Y'all have
show them the jewelry that you regularly
oh,
rock.
Oh, I had this before I went in.
You shining like a disco you know, ball over
it
there.
It breathes. Right? It breathes, so
show
you don't
them
have
the watch.
See you. Yeah, my sister got me. This is techno.
Now everybody know
I
what
mean,
time it
my
is.
My stuff is, you know, I invest.
Official tissue still.
I mean, I can't get VV, you know, big time. All
right. Yo, you got to have your jewelry and jewelry, correct.
I
you
am going to take a pause, right? I'm going to let you talk a little bit more, right, when I get to the spot that I want to highlight. Happy Ramadan.
Oh, thank you. I'm fasting.
Okay.
Yes.
Ramadan you're fasting.
Mubarak. To
and I'm sitting here, soupity slizzard in
shout
what
out
is
to
basics
Freeway,
cut.
Kevin Gates, all the Muslim rappers that's fasting.
What?
Everybody, but fasting. Tell the people
so
what fasting is.
Fasting is a time when you abstain from things that are permissible and not permissible. but it's a full fast. You don't just fast with food. You don't curse. You don't have sex. You don't, you know, listen to certain things. You don't watch certain things. Your feet don't take you certain places. If you're just gonna give up food, but
it's almost like what the Jews do when they do their Passover. And not only their Passover, sometimes they have there's a group in Indiana as well as Pennsylvania of they is what do they call them again, everybody. Help me out here.
More talking about the Mormons?
No, not the, yeah, not the Mormons, but they're the ones. They wear suspenders.
Oh,
you're
talking
like
about
Amish.
The Amish. Shout out to Ezekiel and all the Amish people.
No, I would say that.
It's almost like that, where they give up certain things. It's almost like Lent for the Christians.
Fasting was always in. Jesus fasted 40 days, 40 nights in the Bible.
I used to fast myself, but by force, not choice. I just had no money to get no food. Does that count?
I mean,
it's not even that
that's
counts,
discipline.
Guys.
Obesity has an all-time high.
Right.
But to get back to this thing, you know, it just was. It's a sad thing in America what's going on. How you can be held, and if you have a criminal record, and you be charged, and you put a high bail, if you're innocent to proven guilty. What's the bail and the holding and the bullpen and the system for? That shows that you're guilty to proven innocence. They hold you till you prove that you're innocent to get out. And there's a
and when they hold you, right, for that year and change that you're fighting the situation.
I just got out 4 months ago.
4 months ago. When they hold you for that time, what are the losses that you incur?
You asked that earlier.
I want you to tell the people what happens.
The main loss was... My son grew up right in front of me. You understand?
Without you being there.
And that first year, he only had my voice.
Right.
So I was a voice to him, and I'm still a voice and a physical thing now, but the main thing is I missed a big part of him growing up. But I missed out on opportunities on going on tour. I missed out on opportunities on television. I mean, it's cool because it comes and it goes. Sometimes you have an opportunity, you miss it. Or you don't appreciate the blessing that, you know, Allah put in front of you. And then maybe something else opens and you show more appreciation. But I missed out on that. Mentally, I was shot. I'm afraid to go outside sometimes. I didn't have a secure alibi. So if you're, they had no alibi for me. They didn't accept one. Even though a cop sent one in, a business sent one in. If you don't have some type of, electronic alibi. Your alibi don't stand.
The thing I wanted to ask you was
you
like,
home with your wife and your wife come on the stand. He would sleep with me. Every wife gonna say that.
And that happened. That kind of happened. Believe it, not to cut you off, but that kind of happened. I would look at it like, cause I was in a similar situation, right? It wasn't the whole line played out, but me getting in front of the judge, it was like 23 counts. You feel me? And butter. Was one of the people. I tell people all the time, I don't care how y'all feel. The services that y'all pay for to go see these counselors and all that extra shit, I get that from Butter. Butter's a real friend. Butter talks to me all the time about a lot of shit. And I talk to Butter about a lot of shit that goes on in my life, the ups, the downs. I could call it, have a crazy conversation. And honestly speaking, from my experience, I'm going to be honest with you, bro. The whole system, how it's set up, is honestly set up. I'm not even going to use the color thing. It's just set
it's
up.
Corrupt.
Yeah. And you know what? When you get through it, bro, it's like, yo, hear what? Like, it's just a bigger push in the middle of your back. You don't need no conversation from nobody to tell you, yo, here, do what you got to do. Stay on top. It's your time. That's your encouragement right there. Like, yo, hey, I'm never going through this shit again. Yeah, you feel me?
That's the question I was going to ask you. Like, going forward, like, I tell young niggas all the time, young dudes, young men all the time, because I know the criminal justice system on both sides of the fence. And I ask them one question. I'm like, who you think the most powerful people in the criminal justice system is? And they like, oh, the judge, the CEO, woo-woo. And I'm like, nah. The most powerful person in the criminal justice system is the police officer. Mm-hmm. Because it starts with the police.
Yeah.
They believe him.
But then you end
They're
up.
They're sovereign citizens.
Without them locking you up, you ain't got no case.
But you end up, the last person you see is the Department of Corrections.
Yeah.
You see the judge, prosecutor, grand jury, all that in between that. They're the only ones who don't have discretion. They don't have any discretion at all. They have like mandatory minimums. So my question to you is, when this situation happened and arise, what exactly happened for them to pile up 26 charges, which was trumped, but what was
that's
the situation
just,
when you initially
the
had
white
the arrest?
Talk about it.
I'm talking about in the beginning.
Yeah,
when
the
they
black,
came to fuck with
just,
you
and
for
the black
whatever
and white
reason,
of it, and the
how
black,
did they pile up 26
talk
counts?
About it.
They got an indictment. Before they even came and grabbed me, they built this case.
But I'm saying, when they initially
came
to you, did they like try to
Nah, he just got implicated. He got implicated.
Somebody went with a federal informant. They grabbed somebody. Went to police station. They made a statement. They grabbed them. Took them to the grand jury. They indicted me. They grabbed me from Brooklyn, and they showed me this indictment.
The initial arrest. Was it like some resistant arrest?
No, no, no.
You had a firearm.
They came to the door. They kicked it in. They said I went calmly. I was in a calm state, not involved in no crime.
When you go, you just go.
Yeah, but it's not even just that, too.
Go ahead, Taz.
It's not even just that, too. A lot of things that a lot of people don't know about the system. Let me show you something, right? You catch an individual. They said you assaulted them, right? That individual decided that, yo, listen.
Is this guy.
That's not the right person. The DA, right? Right. When they look at your record, the extensive record, and see how shitty this shit looks,
right.
Guess what they do? They turn around and they pick it up and build a case on you. Yeah. So now it's kind of fucked up where you ended up in there with one situation, and then now it's popping up to be 10, 11, 12 over 6.
They're
going to
think
they think
it's going to stick, but no, you got a long jacket on
they're
you.
The good,
like,
thing is when
for this, so we
the
can
good thing is if
him.
You have a criminal record, but whatever you're locked up for, your last charges don't mirror it.
Right.
Only you did drugs all your life. You get locked up for shooting. I've been a drug. No, you get locked up for drugs all your life. And then you get locked up for shooting. I was a drug dealer. I never was a shooter.
The only time your last charges come up is when they do a PSI with a pre-sentence investigation.
Yeah.
They can take back all the way the shit that you did when you was 11.
Listen, guys, this is the Butters Basic Show every Sunday, 2 to 3 p.m. And I definitely hope that you're enjoying the fact that we are discussing the things at hand that happen to people on a regular basis. I don't want you to misconstrue what we're doing here.
We're
not glorifying. We're talking about what actually happens.
And we're trying to learn.
I want to play you this portion right here. Tasmanian.
And we're
listen to this
to
right
our
here.
Opinions.
So I would like for everyone to appreciate what the minister, Louis Farrakhan, has to say right here in this part.
Now a conspiracy absolutely is in vogue. And I say this humbly, but I've asked certain people who say, well, you're a conspiracy theorist, and they call you the same. I said, but do you read the scriptures of the Bible and Quran? Is not Satan real? Evil is real, so Satan is real. Evil is preponderant in the earth, and that is because the mind of Satan that is being transmitted through religion, through education, through the economics and politics of the situation, so that Satan is in control of a vast enterprise of institutions that foster ideas that put human beings against themselves and against God and against each other.
Put your headphones on.
So there's real conspiracy, and we are in the middle of it as we are dialoguing.
Now,
that really is a revolutionary thought,
a,
that if you question the
just
establishment.
Just take a pause, right? I want everybody to know what they're listening to. This is a conversation between recently banned from Facebook Alex Jones 3 years ago. Has interviewed the Honorable Minister Farrakhan on his own platform, and it was uploaded to the Final Call, which is the Farrakhan site for everything that goes to the newspaper, right? So now he's talking with Farrakhan about the things that are going on right now. And uninterrupted, I just want everybody to take a listen to what's going on here, because this is reality-based situations that we're dealing with, right? Nazi is a Muslim rapper. Do you consider yourself a Muslim rapper?
Yes.
I don't know what else they'd classify you as. You're rocking the, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's what it is. And we're all here together here today on the Butters Basic Show.
He's
a,
and no matter what you call your God, this is what it is. So we're going to just take a listen to a couple of the clips here from Farrakhan. Shout out to Queen Y in the building. Just walked in here.
What's good? I'm representing the nation of gods and earth. What's up, nation?
All right. Peace. So we're going to take a little listen to this right here.
Question what they're saying when they're known liars. You're a conspiracy theorist. That's like saying you're a heretic. Okay, well, if we're a heretic against the system, I guess we're a heretic against the devil. Because this system, undoubtedly, you couldn't call it good. And from my research, that's my concern. The 5%, the 1%, the 1/10 of 1% that actually run and control, manipulate things, they believe they're going to end up winning. They believe that they're getting ahead of people by keeping folks dumbed down. But common sense shows, and just my gut tells me, you don't screw people over and then long term get away with it. It comes back on you. And I think the people serving the system are some of the most deceived out there, because they know how the world really works, but they've decided to basically try to screw over their fellow humans as if they're going to get ahead by doing that. I mean, just anybody who's God-fearing in their gut level has to know that's a lie.
Well, Mr. Jones, in reality, there are those who go along to get along. And there are those who will take money or position or promises of nearness to power to become an instrument of power. They know what they're doing, but they do not know the vast evil that they are a part of. So the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, my teacher, said, we are living now in a very dangerous time.
That's a fact.
He said there never has been a time where on the earth there is 100% dissatisfaction.
I'm gonna take a pause.
Whites are dissatisfied, blacks are dissatisfied, there are Jews and Gentiles that are
Everybody's unhappy with the way that this is going. And I'm going to break towards the next segment right here. Right. So we do segments here at the Butters Basic Show, right? This one right here is called We the People, right? I'm going to skip forward to 4515. And anybody that wants to contact me later on about what I've done here, please feel free. I don't have a problem with that. So here we go here. I want you to listen to this next part at 4515.
I think the type of political correctness that the media and those in power want to promote is robbing.
Just the pause. This is the reason why I'm discussing this part here, because they removed Minister Farrakhan as well as Alex Jones and a couple of others too from social media. Mm-hmm. All right, and this is this is my research that I found as to 3 years ago he already knew. As a prophet, that this was coming. So you take a listen.
Being people of the freedom of thought and speech. I would like to sit with a person and be free to say what is on my heart. And if I'm incorrect, then correct me. But if I have to be politically correct, like Paula Deen, I'd like to bring her up.
Bring her up, Farrakhan.
Now, Paul is from the South. And you know in the South, in the North, when white folk are together, they might say, you know, that nigger or that nigger.
Y'all can ad-lib.
And it's just as common as saying ice cream and pie.
I got called
a
nigger from a parrot.
To black people. Political correctness that robs you.
Said,
of freedom of speech, even if you're wrong. But to punish somebody who has been calling us out of that name or in that name since we've been here, and then take her off of television and make it seem like she's some wicked woman who just used the word. And then our comedians will come on television and you say nigga, 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 nigga all day long. And it's
shout out to the comedians that constantly do it.
Nigga, nigga,
to
nigga, nigga, nigga.
Some a term of endearment.
Mine stopped
but
saying it.
Elijah Muhammad never
I still
wanted
nigga, nigga, nigga,
us
nigga, nigga,
to
nigga.
Use such term in regards to ourselves, and we didn't like anybody using that term toward us. But political correctness, if I disagree with homosexuality, if I disagree with same-sex marriage, if I'm looking at the greatest athlete in the Olympics of
76, and he wants to be a transgender. I struggle with that.
Not too.
To condemn the man like I'm his judge, or condemn the woman who says nigga like I'm the judge, but when we dialogue, we correct misperceptions. That is what makes Trump acceptable to so many white people who feel, damn, I can't.
And this is why they love him, because he tweets to the world how he really fucking feels.
Yeah. But yo, to be honest with you, like,
pay attention to that dude at all.
I was about to say, I'm not even gonna get into that, because that's like, yo, Donald Trump, that motherfucker, he tweets every fucking day, and he tells motherfuckers like, yo, nigga, you ain't shit. Yep. Nigga, you ain't shit. Yo, that's Donald Trump tweeting you, nigga. Mm-hmm. It ain't his fucking rep.
But
it's
I like
Donald
that.
Trump.
I like that so type of
got
shit.
Privilege. He just knows.
I like
I want to say something for the record. Nah,
please do, Nazi.
That I'm a Muslim, but I'm not in the Nation of Islam. And I have nothing to do with
The Nation of Islam.
Even though
is
I
secular.
Don't take away from what Farrakhan did and his articulate speech.
Right.
Malcolm X had articulate speech. Rest in peace. I am a Muslim, a Mu'min. My religion is Islam, and I am not with the Nation of Islam, the Fruit of Islam. But no disrespect to their movement.
Right. Well, I'm with the
For anybody who's watching, you know, respect to the nations of God and earth. You know I got knowledge itself. Mm-hmm. I mean, I could talk certain talk.
Right.
But I'm just, no one mistake.
Right.
Oh, he with the sister. Right. He's the God.
He with Farrakhan.
That's the God.
He a Sunni.
Religion is secular, man. It's like certain versions of in secular parts of Islam, and just like it is with Christianity and a lot of other stuff. Like 5% nation derived from a person that defected for the Nation of Islam.
That's a fact.
What's your religion, Pee Wee?
I ain't got no religion.
What's your religion, Taz?
Honestly, I was brought up in the Christian community, but I ain't gonna lie to y'all. Like,
you're non-denominational right now.
I've been through some shit in my life, so
you prayed for the Jesus, the white Jesus, almighty white Jesus.
I'm gonna keep it 100 with you. Like, this is why I don't believe when people start crying and, oh, Father, Lord, help me. And all
what
that.
About the ladies that roll around on the floor because too much dick
happened?
There
ain't no atheist in a foxhole.
I'm about to
my
tell
nigga.
You something right now, and this is real personal and deep to me, to be honest with you.
You're talking
and
to the world. We're internationally
local.
Yeah,
this is what
tell
I'm saying. Everyone that's in this room, believe it or not, I've been through some shit in my life, and we ain't even gonna go through that. Let's just say I wasn't gonna make it to see 21. All and since that day, I'm about to be 35 in 2 weeks. I have not prayed. I have not prayed from 21 to
now. No, you were
to
supposed
now,
to be here.
I was supposed to. This is what
you
I'm saying.
You wasn't supposed to go
I
at 21, because if you were supposed to go at 21, you would have been gone.
I made that walk to the light and all of that. And you know what I learned? In my experience, you don't have to pray. My mother always taught me a family that stays together, a family that prays together, stays together.
All right.
I woke up on a hospital bed to hearing my mom's voice. Mm-hmm. Saying prayers, reading the Psalms and all of that. And I swear, I'm about to be 35. I don't got to lie to nobody to look cute. I have not prayed since then.
Let me give y'all this right here.
My blessings
you ain't
is
me my
lit.
You, ain't
you feel me?
No,
yeah,
I'm
about
so you
to.
Even ask
no,
me.
Wait, wait, wait. No,
give
because
him ain't
no, I'm just looking at the time, and I'm like,
yo,
what's
stop.
You said you was a 5%.
No, I said I represent the 5% nation.
So then what's your religion if you represent?
I represent them.
But you a Christian? You like the white God? Jesus!
I don't fuck with white people like that too tough.
She prayed a streetology.
Goodness gracious, everyone. This is a disclaimer.
Yeah, but
it has absolutely nothing to do with. Let her
no,
say. Let
she's
her,
allowed to say
I'm
what
let her,
she
let
feels.
Let her say what she feels.
Freedom of speech. I don't mess with whites too tough because I'm not with the buffoonery.
But you give them comedy.
I give them comedy. We don't like to laugh. All but at the end of the day, I'm not into. I don't I represent the 5%ers, but I don't fall under no classification of religion.
Okay.
I'm funnier than you, though.
I just study.
Listen, I'm done with y'all being funny. Listen,
I'm funnier
I want
than
everybody
you,
to listen to this last portion right here.
Let's
with Farrakhan. Right, please and thank you.
When white people don't rub shoulders with us, they cool.
Nothing we can do, I guess. Rub shoulders mainstream media is losing credibility, losing ratings. Even USA Today a few weeks ago admitted.
Guys,
television.
I want you guys to know that the reason why I'm doing this is because Facebook has eradicated major figures from our perspectives.
They eradicated me a couple times, deleted my
account.
I'm
done. I'm muting you right now. Listen.
For politics is dead, it faces its mortality. So I think I just answered my question. They've discredited themselves, but still, they just go on lying, they go on twisting, because I can't disagree with anything you said about standing up for yourself if justice isn't done.
sir, that's what government is for. Mm-hmm. We would like an ordered society. Who wants to see America fall down under anarchy?
Nobody.
But the dissatisfaction in the country is so great.
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. But no foreign power has the right to come into America with money and go to those who are disaffected and pay them to use their arms against their government. Mm. That is something that the American people have to decide. And evidently, the situation in Oregon with the Bundys and the Hammonds that could degenerate into something very violent is a sign. What happened in Waco is a sign. The American people deserve a government that is truly of the people, by the people.
That's not going to happen.
And for the people.
Keep wishing.
They don't have that kind of government as we speak. I hear Mr. Trump and
here's the thing. He's just giving his wishful American thinking, guys. Let him rock.
Rest in peace. Martin Luther King gave it to
back.
And we've been dreaming since.
And my question, Mr. Jones, take it back from whom?
That was my next question.
Khalid Muhammad.
You were alluding to the Federal Reserve. You've been a big critic of for 40, 50 years. Can you speak specifically to the Federal Reserve? You talked about Congress taking its power to print and coin the money back. Like we'll play a clip here where the former Federal Reserve Chairman on Lehrer NewsHour says, oh, the government has no control over us. We run the government. We're above the law. No one can question us. I mean, that is such an incredible statement. I mean, that's the real...
I'm going to let us rock right now.
All right, hold on. Hold on.
Wait, now
I don't want to lose a thought. I don't want to lose a thought. I really don't want to lose a thought. Right?
Just got here.
I'm just saying, honestly speaking, I think this whole conversation and interview that we were just listening to is garbage. I'm just speaking my mind. I'm thinking the conversation is garbage.
And
hold
I
want
to say something too.
I will let you guys know that this is 3 years ago.
It doesn't matter. This is three years ago before
he got kicked off of Facebook.
I
want to
say this too. Like, people be getting it twisted. This is a whole freaking movie going on. We in the Matrix, dog. Farrakhan got a Jewish handler. Let's be for real. He got a handler, and that dude that's talking got a handler, too.
Farrakhan is a government employee.
Thank you. So at the end of the day, like, they're going to say little things because we know certain things right now. We got the internet. We got information. You
Can
feel
I
me?
Say something?
Ahead,
we was enslaved. We came from slavery, and we didn't want to take the religion of...
Enslaved, though.
At a time back, we was, and we didn't want to take the religion of the white man. Mm-hmm. They knew that Islam was going to spread. Mm-hmm. They gave us Islam in the form of the Nation of Islam and said... Don't go to Hajj. Don't go over there. When Malcolm X went to Hajj and he saw that red, white, blue, and people sleeping and eating together, they silenced him. Mm-hmm. They killed him for what? Teaching peace, teaching love. Not white man is the devil, black man is the devil. Well, at the time when white people were teaching black people as devils, nigga, drink out this, excuse my French, drink out this fountain, drink out this fountain. Mm-hmm. You go to this school, go to that school. Mm-hmm. The law in America is if you had a business and served black people, a 7-foot wall, they can't interact with each other.
Yo.
So Malcolm X died on truth.
So guys,
a whole bunch of Nation of Islam left with him.
This is what
and Farrakhan took his shahada and became a Muslim 9-10 times. So, that's neither here or there.
But
so
you
wait,
gotta
guys.
Understand with religion though.
This is why I'm saying.
You gotta take the message from Farrakhan and understand that what he's teaching is black men to clean themselves up.
Oh, yeah. I could talk that right
take
now.
Take the discipline.
Okay. I talk it every day in my neighborhood, bro.
Hear me out. What I'm saying is, I don't take religion for specifics and all that.
So
I take the positive out of it for the structure and the discipline.
So let's pause right there because I got something.
I got something for you guys right now.
Guys, wait.
They killed Malcolm X. Rest
in peace.
I got you.
Mm-hmm. So listen to this right here, right? This is what I want you guys to hear right now.
What's not? So about 90% of the Old Testament's been removed and about 50% of the New Testament's been removed.
Facts.
To put it another way, a normal King James Version has 1,189 chapters in it. The Slave Bible has only 232.
Missing are chapters and verses that might have encouraged uprisings. Book of Exodus, redacted. No story of Moses demanding Pharaoh, let my people go. Gone is Galatians. In the verse, there is neither bond nor free, for ye are all one in Christ Jesus. And no Jeremiah. Woe unto him that useth his neighbor's service without wages.
What they've left in are verses such as Ephesians 6:5, which is the famous verse, slaves, be obedient to your master.
Looking at this Bible, it's hard to tell that anything's been taken out of it.
That's correct. I mean, it looks like a normal book. For many enslaved Africans, this would have been the first time they were exposed to the Bible.
A Bible selectively edited to instill obedience, using religion to underpin the horror of slavery. When people encounter this exhibit, what lasting impression do you want them to leave with?
But we want to pass the message on that may this never happen again. The Bible itself is a whole book. It's not one.
I'm going to pause right there, guys.
White people, the devil, believe this. Don't go over the overseas.
So I want everybody to know here at the Butters Basic Show platform for the unknown to get known. This is not to nitpick who did what and who. I just want everybody to know the reality of what happened so they could understand why it's still happening this way.
Yeah, but
why Nazi has to be a person that goes to a prison for a year and change that gets exonerated because of what you. This is a very complex situation. You know, it's real out here.
It is, but I ain't into the trickery and the foolery at the end of the day either.
Queen Y talking, y'all.
But the bottom line is, when the Constitution and all that was instilled and all that, we were still slaves and thought of less than human and all that. People got to realize,
bananas.
When this country was founded, we wasn't in mind. So you got to understand,
if you look at the laws, the right to bear arms wasn't for us, it was for them.
But it was in mind, all right, to build this shit. We was in mind.
Hear me out. Understand what I'm saying. The bottom line is, when you moving forward in life, you got to take that into consideration. These police is not here to protect and serve you nothing but an ass whooping or put you through the system. So you got to learn how to move a little different through this situation.
They sovereign
citizens. So everybody, we can't sit there and go back and forth about, oh, the system is corrupt. We know it's corrupt.
It's like this, right?
But let's move around this corruption.
I'm watching the time.
Properly
before
we fall into a trap.
Pee-wee, what I want everybody to know that this is Mother's Day here in the United States,
right? Happy Mother's Day to my
mother. I want Nazi to go up by the DJ booth while I, you know, stay for a minute, because I want you to hear this before your performance, right? There's an exclusive that just released on, I watched news outside the United States, and Michael Jackson's mom had something to say about the passing of her son. She just released this interview recently, right? I want you guys to hear. Let's listen, and then we're going to go into this performance and close the show out.
Cute.
All right?
That was the worst day of my life. Never had that feeling before. And I never want to feel like that again.
Had you never feared this day would come?
Never thought this day would come.
I'm going to pause it right there, because there's a portion of it that I definitely want you to hear before the show is over at 13:39.
Death going to come to all of us.
And Mike Jack was Muslim before he died. A lot of people don't know that.
Let's do it.
Suffering, and we didn't know it. And she did.
Paris is still seeking
Paris,
treatment.
Nah, I don't want that part. Paris be all right. Sorry, guys. But I'm going to show you this part.
What's up
right
with
here.
My nigga Blanket, yo? That's Mike. That's the ill ass name.
They have Blanket out
nigga
here.
Blanket.
Word.
Never had that feeling.
You look like my Blanket.
Here we go.
Michael's life began to change from the moment he was severely burned doing the Pepsi commercial.
Yes.
They set the bro on fire and all that.
In 1983, while making the commercial using fireworks, Michael Jackson's hair went up in flames. Did he talk to you about the effect that had upon him?
Yes, because it burned him so badly, his hair wouldn't grow back in the top of his head. Mm. And he didn't like that part of it.
I know he didn't.
So that's when he had to start wearing wigs.
Yes.
But it would be Michael Jackson's changing face that would attract the most attention.
Lord, his nose fell off.
Did you feel your son overindulged?
I'm going to pause on that part.
My man's nose had fell off at Madison Square Garden in a performance one time. He had to keep the microphone to his joint.
Yo, you ain't shit.
Nah, stop.
He's not shit. Why would you say his nose fell off?
It did. That's my nigga and all shit. I love MJ. Yo, stop it.
Yeah, I'm about to divorce you.
Here we go.
That's no my dude. The cry for Michael.
Here we go.
I used to cry for.
Here we go.
Listen, I don't change your looks.
Why, Tito?
Don't treat me like a criminal.
Nah, not Tito.
I am innocent. For Katherine Jackson, the greatest challenges have been the persistent claims of child molestation.
Justice for Michael!
Two boys made allegations against Jackson. In one case, a jury found him not guilty.
Because him and R. Kelly used to run around together too.
And the other did not proceed after payment was accepted from Jackson. How did that impact the
payment
family?
Was
it was hard
I want you guys to know this is
I
my Mother's Day message to everybody.
You had no doubt.
I had no doubt. I knew he didn't do it.
Did you ever ask him?
I didn't have to. We talked about it all the time. We talked about things. Both families lied.
Do you wish that Michael had not paid?
I wish he had, and I got it, and I told him.
As a mother, that makes you angry, doesn't it?
Yes, it does make me angry, because he looked guilty.
Happy Mother's Day, everybody.
But the allegations keep coming.
What is Mother's
Australian
Day?
Wade Robson, a former
today?
Friend and one-time defender of
That's
Jackson,
Listen to who's
is now claiming
him.
He, too,
Nazi,
was molested.
From 7 years old, from day one of the abuse, Michael told me that we loved each other and that this was love, that this was an expression
bananas,
of our love.
Y'all.
And then you follow that up with, you know, but if you ever tell anyone what we're doing, both of our lives and our careers will be over.
Who's talking?
How do you feel about Wade Robson?
The little boy that grew up.
And he know it.
Listen to his mom.
That know it, know Michael. Wade knows better. Wade just wants money. He knows better. He's from Australia, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Yeah, he knows he's lying.
Because he's from Australia, he's lying?
It don't matter, because that's his mother.
Well, his
Happy
mother.
Mother's
he's
Day.
He's like, he was on some bullshit, like, Australian niggas be lying. You know that.
Yo, no, he's from Australia, he's
Listen,
lying.
Listen, let's get that music started. Bananas, we about to close the show out. Yo, Queen Y, where can they find you, hun?
They can find me in these streets. I'm about to be taking it everywhere. Just hashtag the name Queen Y, W-H-Y, don't ask why, it's just a question.
Yo, Pee-wee D, where can they find you, hun?
You can find me in the club like 50. You are?
Smoking
burnt hookah. Buying bitches drinks. I'm sorry.
Listen, you can find him on Instagram at PeeWeeD1.
All day,
you can find me, Butter. I'm a Brooklyn girl all day, every day. I'm internationally local here at Butter's Basics. Man, you can follow the show at Butter_Basics. Follow Gazebo, G-A-Z-Z-E-B-O, and that's with two Z's so you don't sleep. 11210, because I'm a Brooklyn girl all day, every day. Please believe it. Performance by the god, Ak-Nazi.
Yeah, rest that's in peace, mean I love you, 512.
All right. Drop that, Taz. DJ Taz, Mad One.
And rest in peace, Mike Jackson. Since we was on that topic today. This is Bananas right here. I'm nuts.
Lyrically.
I'm bananas.
I'm
nuts. This that nuts. Banana shit.
Beat your chest, nigga.
I'm nuts. Lyrically, physically. Nazi.
Shout out to Casino.
Eight. Gorilla, you ain't no killer. In peace, rest Mike Jackson. Action, go thriller. Run through the city, Godzilla. I was thinking about should I make a hub, but my baby told me go kill him. Ooh, kill him. I'm sitting back and I'm chilling. My pen moving, she rolling up. I'm smoking right in these millions. No Darwin, his theory sucks. Silverback a gorilla. Acapella, we going nuts. Ain't never seen a team realer. You getting money, we loaded up. No guard changing his color. You claim came from the gutter. Charmaine ain't a damn brother. I'm nuts, word to my mother. I'm unlike any other. This world, nigga, no rubber. I go nuts, yeah, cause I love her. I go nuts, yeah, cause I love her.
Rest in peace, Mike Jackson. Shout out to Nige. Woo. That's too loud.
Y'all can hear us?
I'm bananas.
I'm
nuts.
Nuts.
It's that nuts, banana shit.
Lyrically, I'm nuts.
Chess,
nigga.
I'm nuts. Lyrically, not physically. Nazi. Shout out to Casino. Eight, Gorilla. You ain't no killer. In peace, rest Mike Jackson. Action, go thriller. Run through the city, Godzilla. I was thinking about should I make a hook, but my baby told me go kill him. Ooh. gon' kill him. I'm sitting back and I'm chilling. My pen moving, she rolling up. I'm smoking right in these millions. No Darwin hysteria, some silverback a gorilla. Acapella, we going nuts. You ain't never seen a team realer. You getting money, we loading up. No guard changing his color. You claim came from the gutter. Charlemagne ain't a damn brother. I'm nuts, word to my mother. I'm unlike any other. This raw nigga, no rubber. I go nuts here cause I love her. I go nuts here cause I love her. Why you niggas wanna test me? Good fellas, nigga, no pesky. Got a big yacht and a jet ski and a bunch of guns, come test me. I live around all these animals. I eat them up like a cannibal. My nickname should be Hannibal. My nickname should be Hannibal. I'm at your door like Ding Dong. Scoop up your bitch like King Kong. Ain't gotta cheat, I just bring home. Got Acapella on a ringtone. I'm at your door like Ding Dong. Scoop up your bitch like King Kong. Ain't gotta cheat, I just bring home. Got Acapella on a ringtone. 8 Gorilla. You ain't no killer. In peace, rest Mike Jackson. Action, go thriller. Run through the city, Godzilla. I was thinking about should I make a hook, but my baby told me go kill him. Kill him, ooh, kill him. 8 Gorilla. You ain't no killer. In peace, rest Mike Jackson. Action, go thriller. Run through the city, Godzilla. I was thinking about should I make a hook, but my baby told me go kill him. Kill him, ooh, kill him.
Save the best for last, bitches. Shout out to Dillinger, the producer. Boom!
The best ever. Nazi. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Perfect. I was gonna rip his heart out. I'm the best ever. I'm the most brutal and vicious and most ruthless champion there's ever been. There's no one can stop me.
No one can
I'm the best ever.
Best ever.
I'm Sonny Liston. I'm Jack Dizzy. There's no one like
I'm from
there. Like I said, we rocking DTF Radio. Let's go.
Acapella, nigga, pass me. Hit him where his hat be. Killing any trap beat. I'm from the East Bay. Voices getting raspy. Looking with the streets made, but my lyrics classy. Questions that you ask me. Looking with my cash beat. Keep that thing close, man. Nigga, gotta pass me. How like accomplices. Look at my accomplishments. Came a long way from hustling up on a project bench. Got it locked without a wrench. Smell it if I got a pinch. Everybody got something to say. Ain't that a bitch? Tough, tough, passing it. Black and half Arabic. Roaches in my cereal box. Looking sad as shit. Fuck if I ain't mastering. Hobby in my casket rich. Acapella getting in time years after it. Get up on my past and shit. Kick and start the hacking shit. Better watch. Ha! I grew up hot. A bastard kid. Ha! They was laughing cause my skin wasn't black as them. Coolie here. Grew up in a house full of Africans. Now I start spitting. Everybody start jacking them. Ran through a plate in 1 week. I got a sack again. Fuck what a nigga gotta say. I'm the best dog. Getting airplay on the east and the west dog. This is just a freestyle. Did it just to bless y'all. Line up on the chow, nigga. This that mess hall. Acapella there, nigga, pass me. Hit him where his hat be. Killing any trap beat. I'm from the East, Dave. Voices getting raspy. Looking what the streets made, but my lyrics classy. Questions that you ask me. Looking with my cash beat. Keep that thing close, man. Nigga, gotta pass me. How like accomplices. Look at my accomplishments. Came a long way from hustling up on the project bench.
Perfect. I was gonna rip his heart out. I'm the best ever. I'm the most brutal and vicious and most ruthless champion there's ever been. There's no one can stop me. Lynx is a conqueror. No, I'm Alexander. He's no Alexander. I'm the best ever. There's never been anybody as ruthless. I'm Sonny Liston. I'm Jack Dempsey. There's no one like me. I'm from Nairclaw. There's no one that can match me. Perfect.